Michael Okpara University of Agriculture, originally the Federal University of Agriculture, is a federal university in Umudike, Abia State, Nigeria, established as a specialized university by a federal government of Nigeria decree number 48 of November 1992. It began formal activities on the 27th of May 1993 with the motto, Knowledge, Food and Security. The first set of students was admitted into the university during the 1993-1994 academic year with a total population of 82. Michael Okpara University of Agriculture Umudike, also known as MUAU, is located in the Agricultural Training and Research City of Umudike, about 10 kilometers from Umuahia, capital of Abia State, southeast Nigeria. The vision of the university is, among others, to be the foremost institution for producing high-rated graduates in agriculture, science and technology, and to be a vehicle for the attainment of the primary goals of the National Agricultural Policy and self-sufficiency in food and fiber production. Her mission is to provide high-quality practical training to students to become professionally competent and confident persons capable of self-employment, to develop environment-friendly and people-sensitive technologies, and to enable the well-being of the people through extension and other interventions. Since the establishment of the university in 1993, four vice-chancellors have steered the ship of this citadel of learning located in the southeast of Nigeria. The vice-chancellors include Professor Placid Njoku, who served between 1993 and 1999. He was succeeded by Professor Obonnaya Onwudike, who served from January 2000 to February 2006. Professor Ikenna Onyedo took over and served from March 2006 to February 2011. Great achievers and leaders are known not only by their words but by their indelible footprints on the sand and landscape of time and places they pass through. Professor Hilary Odo Edoga is unarguably one of the great leaders. This is because he bequeathed to Michael Okpara University of Agriculture Umudike an uncommon and positive change ever experienced by the institution since her inception. Professor Hilary Odo Edoga took over the mantle of leadership from 2011 after he was meritoriously appointed the fourth Vice-Chancellor, MUAU. He holds BSc, MSc, PhD in Botany and became a Professor of Plant Taxonomy and Cytogenetic at the age of 41. He has served in various capacities including as Honorable Commissioner for Agriculture and Natural Resources, Enugu State, Senior Research Advisor, Shell Petroleum Development Company, Nigeria Limited, Port Harcourt, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, Michael Okpara University of Agriculture, Umudike, Dean of Postgraduate School, MUAU, Head of Department of Biological Sciences, Michael Okpara University of Agriculture, Umudike. Professor Edoga has over 120 publications, including journals, books, technical papers, and reports. He has successfully supervised several students at the undergraduate, master's, and doctorate levels. Also armed with a great wealth of academic and administrative experience, and as one of the outstanding pioneer academic staff of the university, and with a vision to re-engineer MUAU, he settled down with a vantage for excellent performance. This academic icon, in his inaugural speech, made it clear that he will take creative administrative and other far-reaching measures to place MUAU on the global map through improvements of the welfare of the staff and students, rapid infrastructural development, and sound extension services.
My name is Professor Hilary Odeyedoga. I was born to the family of Chief and Mrs. Manuel Edogo Genyes of Amede Village, Amfis, a local government area in Enugu State in the year 1960, to be precise, 28 November. I'm currently the Vice Chancellor of this university. I attended the University of Port Harcourt, and I'm married to Georgina Bizube Edoga, a marriage blessed with three lovely children, Izuchukwu, Nenna, and Ogonna. Actually, I have been a part of this system, so to say, the part of this university. In fact, all my life I have worked in the university from 1988 to date. And having been a former head of department of this university, in this university, a former dean of a college, a former dean of postgraduate studies, a former deputy vice chancellor of this university, I was equipped with the required knowledge of the challenges of the university. And I had that zeal to train leaders, produce leaders, not just graduates, but leaders. Having been equipped with all these experiences, I had no choice than to submit myself during the time the advertisement was made. And luckily, God heard my prayers, and I was selected as the best of about 9 or 11 candidates in that exercise. Precisely, I took over in the year 2011, first March to be precise. I'm believing on 28th of February 2016, making it 5 years. If you look at far back as 2011, first March to be precise, if you look at the structural landscape of the university, if you look at the human resource base of this university, if you look at the position of this university in terms of ranking among Nigerian universities, you will see that we're almost there. In fact, the last ranking of Nigerian universities, this university was placed 29th out of more than 100 universities in the country. Today, people have known that this university is located in Abia State. No more the obscure period where people can't even locate this university in the world map. Today, this university is now boasting of more than 17,000 students or candidates itching to come and be students here. Before I came on board, the population of students who used to subscribe to this union was less than 4,000. But today, we are talking of almost 18,000. Today, the quota of admission is now 4,000 plus. Previously, used to be 1,250. So, already there. You can see the time hosters, the generator sets, the classroom infrastructure, the laboratories, the vehicles for deans, the OMR machine, the radio station, and you can see how many PhD holders we have produced or attracted, professors. At least this university has no less than more than 100 professors now, unlike before. So these are the areas we have done, shown our improvement, and as such, places that areas that are worth commending.
To appreciate the landmark contributions of Professor Odoga's administration to the rapid growth and development of the university, it is necessary to go down the memory lane of the state of structure in Muayu when he came into saddle of leadership. With this state of things, this focused administrator and change agent per excellence has in the last 5 years tremendously and positively changed the face, body and soul of Muayu to the admiration of all. For instance, comparative analysis of his achievements with the previous VCs in the area of students' welfare, Professor Edogor undertook a monumental effort at bettering the lots of the students in the area of hostel accommodation, construction of large lecture and examination halls, furnished the classrooms with modern seats, equipped the laboratories to high standard, and generally set the university environment to be conducive for learning.